the fields in which the EMBL is particularly strong is data science, and that's why I became so interested in the Pan Cancer Project, a project where scientists from over 30 countries work together and share their data. That fascinated me. My name is Jan Korbel. I'm the head of data science at the EMBL. I also lead a research group at the EMBL in the Genome Biology Unit. And we want to understand how cancers emerge and particularly how mutations in our hereditary code contribute to the development of cancer and other diseases. Scope-wise, the Pan Cancer Project looked at 2,600 cancer genomes. So we had the hereditary code of 2,600 people from all across the globe, and it needed modern methods in data science, so modern computational methods to analyze it. In many organs of the human body, cells duplicate all the time, and the duplication process means that all the chromosomes have to be remade. This process works extremely efficient, but there are still errors, and the errors can eventually cause you cancer. In terms of technologies, one cannot simply read out the DNA of a person like one reads a book. Currently, what we need to do is we need to chop up the chromosomes into very small pieces. And these small pieces, they're called reads, are then becoming analyzed through a process called sequencing. And my laboratory does actually both. We are a so-called hybrid laboratory that both performs molecular biology experiments in the laboratory. And we're sitting at computers and developing new methods to analyze the data. The key findings of the Pan Cancer Project were that we could, for the first time, catalog across the world the full spectrum of changes that can occur in the book of life, as we sometimes call the genome. What we learned from this is not just which type of mutations occur and which type of cancer, but we also could time them. That it tells us also when were the most important mutations for the first time occurring in that patient. And we find that that's sometimes years before the patient runs to the clinic and undergoes surgery. That is also good news for us. Our genome doesn't determine everything. The environment plays a crucial role. In the Pan Cancer Project, we integrate environmental information by looking at certain types of changes in the genome that tell us about the environment that the patient has been exposed to. That's actually quite interesting. We can read out from the genetic code how often the patient has gone sunbathing in the Mediterranean, because we see mutations that are caused by UV light very clearly in some tumors. And patients cannot hide their smoking habits from us either, because mutations lead to very specific signature of mutations in our genome. So sometimes a person may not dare to tell us how much they have smoked, but we will see it in the genome, and that also helps us to understand how the environmental exposure plus genetic mutations interact to cause a certain clinical condition. We were lucky enough that some of our findings are already used in the clinics. Those pertain largely to rare mutations in the hereditary code, which can lead to children to develop certain brain cancers. And there's now clinical recommendations based on our findings. But we can also potentially do something with that information in the future. Once knowing the important mutation, we're now beginning to understand them. We can perhaps in the future design new ways to identify a tumor before it becomes dangerous in a patient. And that is, some people say, the holy grail of cancer treatment, to not having to treat a cancer, but to catch it before it develops and prevent it before it can harm a patient.